Hey everyone, Sam McKay here from Enterprise DNA. I want to revisit a technique here that I call multi-threaded dynamic visuals. Okay, and I want to revisit it because I think that the content deserves a bit of a refresh, and I want to just efficiently talk through the technique here because it's got so many uses inside of Power BI. You can utilize it in so many different ways. And I think that going over how you can incorporate this is going to be very valuable for those who've been connected with Enterprise DNA for a while, or even and very much so for those who are new to the channel and our content and really trying to master Power BI, because you'll get a lot out of just this one technique or a bunch of techniques all molded into one, really, to actually create this this way that you can visualize data. So what we've got here, this particular resource, you can actually download. This is one resource that we do make available to anyone. You don't have to be on our membership program or have upgraded at all. You can just go to our resources page, which is on the just at the Enterprise DNA website, and you can actually download this very resource, right? So we've updated our resources page, got a lot of really great stuff here that you can download for free, and you can actually download this particular one. But I want to walk you through it so you can have a good idea of how it sort of works. So the idea here, right, in terms of the multi-threading of visuals that we're doing here, the dynamic way that we can flick through visuals, is that we can say select things or filters together within and change what visualizations are. So we're here looking at, say, sales information, and I'm saying, okay, well, I want to look for the last 14 days and I want to look at profits. So I can select those two things and every single thing in my chart is going to change. And I've also got three layers here where I'm looking at different regions on the East Coast of the US as well. So I've actually broken it up with some additional filtering within my report page. So you see here that just by using your imagination, there's so many different ways that you can make your reports represent certain things, right, or represent certain insights. It's just a matter of thinking wider in terms of what's possible. So I'll show you some simple stuff first, like how have I broken out these three different layers inside of my report page. So here, because these all come from one table, it's all one model, one table, nothing. So this is just a really simple model, one I use quite often. You know, it's just the waterfall technique, and I've got three layers here. All I've done is I've utilized this filter area here, and for each different visualization, I've then changed the states in which we're looking at, right? And so I've broken it down that way. So instead of just having one for everything, I've said, okay, I want to focus on the bottom of the East Coast, the middle of the East Coast, and the top of the East Coast, one after the other. Then, okay, so this is where we get into the more nitty-gritty of this technique, is how do we create one measure that we can place into every single visual here and get it to change based on any selection we make? Because what's interesting here is, check this out, if I select all of these visuals, the very same measure is being used in every single one. It's only one measure, right? That one should actually, I should actually update that, sorry about that. That should be updated too. Okay, cool. So everything's exactly the same, right? So let's go to this measure and start from the top, and we'll work our way back, right? So if we have a look at this particular measure, look at this one. It's very simple, okay? It's a switch true technique where we're saying, okay, if the, and what I've done with values here is, you could also use a function called selected value. That's absolutely no problem as well. But I've utilized values here. So if the selected value is revenue, then I want to return my total revenue measure. If the selected value is profits, I want to return my total profits measure. Okay, so just using a simple switch true statement, we have now been able to work out or change between what measure we show by this selection in here. Okay, but this doesn't solve for this date thing, which we need, this date change up that we need as well, this date thread that we need to change as well. But that's a simple way just to create one level of dynamic visuals, right? Just utilizing switch true and feeding measures in. But what if we wanted to add different layers, different threads to it, just like we have with this date here, right? Well, what we've got to do is we've got to dive into those particular measures that are feeding into here. And so this is where they are here, these date ranges. And I'm going to go and have a look at our total revenue measure. Let's have a look at how this one is formulated, right? I'm calculating up revenue, but I'm going to change the context in which I calculate up my revenue, right? And I'm going to change the context by filtering by how many days we want to look at. And how many days we want to look at is going to be determined by the total days. And this total days is fed from that selection that we are making, right? It's saying if that time, if there is one selection made on this time frame slicer, then I want to count up how many days, I want to count up how many days are within that particular range, right? How many days are within that particular range? And this is very simply derived from, it is derived from this particular table which is sitting in behind this particular slicer. And so if I come to that particular table here, I'm going to go and find my date ranges. You'll see here that my timeframes have specific days next to them like that. And so all I'm doing is I'm picking up how many days to feed into that filter area inside of Calculate via that table, right? And so you see here that is going to change now based on any selection that I make in that particular table, because that total days is going to change. Okay, and then I've done exactly the same for total profits, right? So you see here that my profits now can adjust based on any selection on days, and then that's going to then feed up into the switch true statement, which comes through over here, okay? So once we've set it up like that, we can then place that same measure into any of our dimensions here, because these dimensions are all coming from our lookup table layer up the top here, right? And now these visuals in our report are totally dynamic with that additional filtering that we've put on here. So we can just my mind blows up here in terms of like what you can what you can put inside of your reports if you just think really broadly around, you know, how your consumers might want to enjoy, you know, viewing and having a look at your information. And to me, from a user experience perspective, this is a pretty high level report, right? It's a pretty high level way of analyzing how things are going across all the different stores you might have in a range of different regions. And it's so easy, say you were doing a presentation, to sort of put this up, you know, on a big screen and, you know, talk your way through it, right? Put it up on a big screen. This could be on the online service as well, automatically updating with the data gateway, etc. You know, this is some pretty high quality stuff. Okay, so just a quick review there. Hopefully you got some good ideas out of that. I think that in terms of this technique, it's as relevant today as it was when I first dreamt it up and talked about it on the channel. So hopefully if you haven't seen it, you've got a really good technique to put into your pocket and bring it out when it's valid and in some sort of development work that you're doing. Okay, so I'm going to round things off there. Hopefully you enjoyed this one. All the very best. Definitely throw the video a like if you got a lot out of it and you're getting a lot out of the ideas and techniques that we're showcasing on the channel. Really appreciate it. And hey, don't forget to subscribe. Plenty of great content coming out to you very soon. Okay, all the best.